just when I'd begun to get myself together. You waltz right in the door, just like you've done before, and wrap my heart round your little finger. Here you come again, just when I'm about to make it work. You look into my eyes, and lie those pretty eyes. I'm wondering how I came to doubt you. All you gotta do is smile that smile, and let go all my defenses. Just leave it up to you, and in a little while, you're messing up my mind, filling up my senses. Here you come again, looking better than a body has a right to, and shaking me up so that all I really know is see you come again.
Recording from Lesley Gore from the mid to late 1970s, a cover of Dolly Parton, of course, Here You Come Again. Well, at Sarah Lawrence College for Women, her secondary education, Lesley Gore took courses in literature and drama. And as she would recall in a 1970s interview, I was a good student. I enjoyed the school. As she said of her experiences at the school, the campus was a kind of haven for me, a beautiful school with an excellent philosophy. They treat women like human beings, and they were doing that back then even. I felt really good to feel good about being a woman, and Sarah Lawrence College had a lot to do with helping me feel that way. Well, we left Lesley Gore in 1964, and we're going to continue that year as her string of hits just kept on coming. As we said, the flip side of Hey Now, which was a 64 hit, was a song called Wonder Boy. It made a two-sided hit for Lesley Gore in the summer of 64.
Wonderful, wonderful, if you're so small.
featured artist on Look for a Star, Lesley Gore. Look for a Star, she is the star, the late Lesley Gore. Well, it comes a time in my program weekly here that I like to pick my favorite song and share it with you from our star featured artist, and that time has come. It was 1964, and a 17-year-old Lesley Gore was singing a hit after hit that year, and I was one of the fans of that music. I can still see those Black Mercury labels with the silver printing on them spinning on my turntables, and this particular 45 I bought, and I played it literally through to the other side. The song was called That's the Way Boys Are, and I don't know if it just resonated with me or what, but this song is just, it just puts goosebumps on my arm to hear it again. Here's Lesley Gore with her top 20 hit from the summer and spring of 1964. That's the Way Boys Are. Sounding as good or even better today than it did back in 1964. That's the way boys are. Well, while my arms recover from the goosebumps of hearing that one more time, let's take a look at that last fall hit recording that Lesley Gore released in the fall of 1964. Just as good and sounding just as boss. Here's Hey Now.
What you gonna do? Stay.
1964 would be the last big year for Lesley Gore's hit after hit after hit would just kept coming through that year. Indeed, she was seen as a sweetheart of America. Her audience was loyal, and she was in college discovering her own sexuality as she sang these songs. Here's from the late fall of 1964, one of her last of that year. Sometimes, maybe there's something else in this song that to read into it. It's called Sometimes I Wish I Were a Boy.
Sometimes, yes, sometimes I wish I were a boy. I've been standing by the jukebox, hoping he'd ask me to dance. How I wish I could run to him and hug him, but a girl mustn't make an advance. Oh, I'm a girl and it's wonderful. It fills my heart with joy. But sometimes, yes, sometimes I wish I were a boy. Oh, he's dancing with another, and he's holding her so tight. Wish I had nerve to cut right in and stop.
It was while attending college at Sarah Lawrence College in New York that Lesley Gore realized truly that she was a lesbian. Before college, she explained she simply had never had the time to examine her own true feelings because of the success of her and demands of her career. I had boyfriends, she said in a later interview. I was even scheduled to get married. All of that was part of the agenda of the times, but part of the problem that I had was being out in the public. It was hard to even explore my own feelings, she said. I wasn't even left the opportunity, and at that time, when I'd talk to some of my gay women friends, who might just be a little bit older than me, they would come in from Long Island and New Jersey, and they would put on their black Levi's and black jackets and run out to the New York bars. Well, I wasn't able to do that because I was a public figure. She never would marry, and she never had any children. We're going to take a break, and when we come back, we'll listen to Lesley Gore in a personal feelings song. The song's called The Road That I Walk.